Welcome to this video tutorial on how reviewers should download and manage application materials from IAR that are protected by the Digital Rights Management DRM process. To help ensure the security and confidentiality of review materials, DRM encrypts downloads such as application packages, prior summary statements, etc. to maintain peer review integrity. This video tutorial demonstrates the steps you should take to navigate downloads with DRM. As a reminder, you are prohibited from sharing applications, proposals, or meeting materials with anyone who is not officially designated to participate in the peer review meeting. This includes, but is not limited to, colleagues, lab members, fellows, students, applicants, offerers, or employees of an offerer. It is very important to note that DRM works with Adobe on a per-device basis, such as a laptop or desktop computer. Once you've completed the initial steps, you will not have to repeat them for future meetings unless you change devices. Three steps to take before accessing application materials in IAR. Configuring Adobe. Step 1. Add the NIH.gov domain name as a trusted site to Adobe. Click on Adobe Acrobat on your device. Go to Edit, then Preferences for Windows, or Acrobat, then Preferences for Mac. Depending on your version of Adobe, you may need to select Menu, then Preferences. Select Trust Manager in the left pane, and then click the Change Settings button in the Internet Access from PDF Files outside the Web Browser section. In the Specify Websites to Allow or Block, type in https://nih.gov in the host name field and click Allow button. You see that nih.gov has been added to the websites field. Click OK on the Manage Internet Access screen to save the changes. Step 2. Disable Adobe's Global Object Security Policy. Taking this step saves time, as you will not need to provide your user ID and access key each time you want to open a review document. From the same Adobe Preferences screen, select JavaScript in the left pane, and then clear the checkbox or uncheck Enable Global Object Security Policy. Then click on OK to close the Preferences screen. Close Adobe and restart it to ensure the changes have been enabled. Step 3. Use Adobe Acrobat as the default program to open PDFs. For Windows, right-click on the thumbnail of any PDF file. On the menu, click Properties. A new dialog box appears. In the first subsection, the text Open With indicates which PDF viewer is set as your default. Click the Change button. Select Adobe Acrobat DC or Reader from the list. Click OK to save and apply the change. For Mac, right-click on the thumbnail of any PDF file. On the menu, click Get Info. Go to the Open With section and select Adobe Acrobat DC or Reader from the drop-down list. Click Change All to apply this change for all future PDF documents. Accessing DRM-protected files in IAR. Once you've logged into IAR, on the List of Meetings screen, click the three-dot ellipsis icon and select the View List of Applications option. This opens the List of My Assigned Applications screen. Click the Download button. You will see from the drop-down that this is a DRM meeting by the badge displayed at the top of the menu. Click the Assigned Applications zip option. Note that you can also return here to retrieve the current access key if needed. You see the Assigned Applications zip download instructions window. There's some important information presented here that you want to note. This is a one-time activity to register the device, and the access key is time-sensitive and it will expire after the date and time displayed here. Click the Copy button to copy the access key, as you will need it the first time you open a file. Click Continue with Download. You may wish to keep this window open so you can retrieve your user ID and the access code again once you go to open a file. Navigate to the downloaded zip file. Unzip or extract the assigned application zip file. Right-click on the zip folder and select Extract All. select where you want the files to be extracted to, and click the Extract button. Note, if you are connected to a network by a VPN, the VPN connection can disrupt the extraction process, resulting in empty folders. Be sure to disconnect from VPN before extracting the zip folder. Navigate to the extracted folder. Within the Applications folder will be subfolders, one for each application assigned to you. Open a selected application folder and open a PDF file. If Adobe Acrobat is not your default application to open a PDF file, then right-click on the file and choose Open with Adobe Acrobat. A login page opens with fields for your ERA Commons user ID and the access key from the assigned application zip download instructions window. The access key field is where you can paste in the key data that was copied from the download instructions window. Complete these fields and click Login. It may take a few seconds to verify your access to the documents and register your device. Once that process is complete, the application materials are displayed and your device is registered, and you can access other files from the downloaded zip. Note, the documents will display a diagonal watermark as a reminder to reviewers to maintain confidentiality. Confidential, NIH use only, do not distribute nor disclose. A few reminders. Configure Adobe before downloading any materials. This is a one-time process for each device you use. The access key expires at midnight Eastern Time each night, and a new key is then generated. If you don't open a document before the current key expires, you will need to access IAR and retrieve the latest key. You have access to meeting materials until the review meeting ends or until your access as a reviewer is disabled. Resources. There are a number of additional resources that are available to you for IAR if you need them. If you are having technical issues with IAR, please contact the ERA Service Desk. This concludes this video tutorial on IAR's Digital Rights Management DRM process. We very much appreciate your service as a reviewer and for doing your part to keep confidential and sensitive review materials safe and secure. Thank you for watching.